Hi guys, and welcome back to Football Manager 2018 here with Ajax in our Youth Academy Challenge. About to take on PSV Eindhoven away from home, but first of all, the Heeren Veen NEC result. Last time we seen NEC at home against a team higher up, they battered Feyenoord 6-1. No such repeat today as they go down 3-2 against Heeren Veen. Now, Feyenoord host Heracles today, which you would expect them to win as we go away to PSV. They're in woeful form, and we put them out the cup earlier on this season at our home stadium, fair enough, but we should still expect to get something here as Backboard comes back into the side. Savastano sadly suspended, so Kemper will continue on his side of the park. Injuries and suspensions hurting our team selection so far. Sir House comes back in for Koning today. Unfortunately, Savastano and Veltman both miss out. Farkas will come out today. No, in fact, Zifoik will come out for Van Gilderen, who's right-footed. Farkas left-footed, if I recall correctly. Indeed. So, I think, let me just do a quick scan through. I think that's going to be our lineup today. We'll keep Maddie on, or we'll go for Cliver. We'll have to go with the main man today. So it's Roy Grock, Van Gilderen, Delight, Farkas, Backboard, Kemper, Van de Beek, Aiting, Clivert, Seerhouse and Decker. Let's actually look at pace. Is it okay pace for Farkas? Delight is okay pace as well, so we might as well just keep Farkas wide. I was just thinking there about runs in behind from wingers to see if perhaps one of them was quicker to catch a winger, but they're both more or less the same. And Delight likes to be the man in the middle of the three, so we'll allow him to do that. Show some passion today, guys. There's a derby here today. A draw is not the worst result, to be honest, here away from home against a team that will be up for it against us. Regardless of how poorly they're doing actually in their season, they will be up for it against us to try and spoil the party a little bit. As Van Crooy again scoring for Feyenoord. Paulinho floats it in deep, it's nodded down, and Ricardo Kishna turns it in. Demand more, this is not good enough. Decker looks a bit knackered. Let's hope an immediate equaliser. Van de Beek in. It's headed away. Come on, Donny, get it back in. Acres of space to pick a cross. It's a shocker of a cross from him. And Kishna's going to get away with this one. Paulinho into De Jong. Brennett arriving, but Board wins it. Kishna gets it. Squares it. Paulinho. Oh, it's a sitter from Suarez in the middle of the box there. It should be 2-0, it is one apiece in the other game actually. Heracles equalising up, but then Van Crooy again managing to make it 2-1. Feyenoord, Paulinho to De Jong, and Brennett and Kishna, Akers and shoots and save. We are not tracking Kishna at all today. Not even that we're tracking him poorly, we're just no tracking him. Sosa's cross in, header away by Kemper, we're really nobbing at their aces. Kishna's ball back in, goes past everyone. Nuno Santos back the way to Suarez. Come on, surely that's the end of this. Schwab, and it is eventually the end of it. Absolutely nothing to be happy about in this first half. Kishna now, Suarez, Brennett, Paulinho, out wide, Santos, De Jong. We just can't touch them, we can't get the ball. Schwab for De Jong, it's too deep, it's Kishna it's the post. Roy Grock out, Farkas, can we spoil this half for them here? Can we snatch something we don't deserve? Kemper back to Farkas. I was going to say more likely is that they nick it and bury us. De Jong, not a great pass, but Schwab gets it on a pose that's deep for Kishna, away by Backboard. Suarez will get it easily, it keeps coming back at us. Schwab drives it low, Delight away, back at us again. Schwab with another chance to put it into the box. Sosa, Suarez, we're chasing shadows here. Santos, Schwab, deep away. Farkas helps her on, back at us again from Suarez. Sosa, Suarez, Brennett, Kishna's got acres again. And he just walks into the net. I mean, for fuck's sake, what was that? Shocking half. Absolutely abysmal. They're not even trying. Right, Decker's at least half dead. Nunnally can come on. Maddie can come on as well. Clivert and Decker offered nothing, and okay, as I say, at least Decker was half dead, but Clivert's just been posted missing again. I feel sorry for Backboard because he's been absolutely doubled up on time and again today with no help. Farkas has had a stinker. Everybody's had a stinker, actually. Only Delight and Rug Rock have decent-ish ratings. And Backboard, actually. Somehow. Despite the fact his man Kishna's the one that's done all the damage. Speaking of damage, and Kishna always lost it to Kemper, but somehow Schwab gets there ahead of four of our players. Back to Schwab again, unopposed practically. Kishna now, Nuno Santos over the bar. We should have had the break there numerous times, and we've just let them get it. Okay, chance here, Backboard Maddy, put a good one in. Nope, shocker, Sosa away. Picked up by Delight, in again over the top, away again. Carl Eating, given away to Nuno Santos, who can pass it out to Paulinho. Doesn't even have to clear it, just passes it. Suarez now switching it to Brennett. This has been abysmal. Kishna now. Crosses De Jong, just over. Okay, it's time to either equalise or get a battering. Let's go for the throat. As I say, we'll either equalise here or we'll get absolutely slaughtered. Carl Eating is off for Noah Lang. We'll push Noah Lang to the attacking role. Drop Van de Beek back deeper. Corner. Van de Beek in. Header away. Kishna on the break. Come on. It's easy for Meister. On the ball. Five shots. Trailing nowhere near him. And Nicholas Meister has absolutely bitched us there. About five players just couldn't catch him. And they watch him roll it in for 3-0. This is the worst we've played in the league for a long, long time. In a normal season against a PSV Eindhoven side, you could probably accept something like this happening. But how poor they've been this season, this is a shocker of a result. So your house cushions it down, and Nunnally has got it into the net. Possibly a lifeline. It's a pity we couldn't have done this before they scored their third. Kemper now throwing it. Come on, get a quick 3-2 and you never know. Kemper to Nunnally now. Switching the play. That's a shocker. Kishna again doing the work. Tracking back and intercepting the ball. It's dumped for Meister to chase. Farkas should just get it back to the keeper. Goes across to Van Gelder and that's fine too. Back board now. Maddy going to make a run? He is. Come on, race him. Oh, come on, son. Who is... I don't even know what to say about that. Yeah, it looks like a routine 3-1 for PSV today, to be honest. If we could snatch one now, then we can at least make it an exciting finish, but it looks like we're going to get thoroughly slapped down today as Zoet makes another good save to deny Maddy. Van de Beek's corners away again. Second corner, away again. Third corner to be taken. Probably just going to be away again. It is indeed away again. His backboard picks it up, finds Lang. His shot well wide of the post. And it's an even game today, 50-50 possession. 15 shots to their 14, 6 on to their 7. But we've never been in it, really. The statistics lie, to be honest. Nunnally scores for 3-2, and we do not deserve this. Scoreline flatters us, the stats flatter us. We've been a bit better in the second half, but all too easy for them all day. I mean, Kishna should have a hat-trick easily, and it ends 3-2. Not a good performance. Aggressively telling them it's not a good performance, and Feyenoord are back within 7. Feyenoord are back within 7, and they still have to come to our place, which if they win that game, that's only 4 points that they have to make up between now and playing that game. And if we continue to drop performances like that, it could well happen. I mean, look at the last game. Heracles in the cup, we were okay. Roda though, we threw away points, and we've barely turned up against PSV Eindhoven. They were missing Veltman, I dare say. We missed Savastano that game as well. We do miss these big players when they're out. The youth intake should be coming up really, really soon, actually, and we need a good one. A wonder kid left fullback, preferably. Savastano's a good player, and we miss him when he's not there, but I'd like him to be the understudy preferably. I don't think he's somebody who's going to win as a Champions League. I think, oh there you go, Kluivert's new contract and he's set to stay, thank God for that. That Real Madrid game is looming large there on the horizon. It could be a real bad hammering this time as well. We're at home, but I still don't see us getting anything from it. Best we can do, try and avoid defeat on the day, but overall just avoid embarrassment really is all we can ask for. Veltman's still unable to play, of course. And I think past couple of games have shown how we've missed him. We conceded one against Heracles, conceded two against Roda, conceded three against PSV. We've certainly missed the big man at the back. That's why he can't leave. Well, we're still building up all these youngsters here to get some experience. We need somebody that already has the built-in experience, like Veltman. Now it is time to face Zvoli, who we play on the Sunday when we're playing on the Wednesday. That's harsh. We should be a Saturday game here to give us time to prepare for Real Madrid. Apparently the league doesn't care about that. AZ Breda here is really the only one that's kind of interesting to us. I would think even AZ in third are too far behind to matter to us. They do get the win, jump up to second. What does that bring them within? That brings them within six. In fairness, they could still be interesting to us. Anything else of note happening today? I don't think so. PSV were playing, but they don't matter. They win 2-1 against Go Ahead Eagles. Groningen lose to Den Haag, which keeps them 11 behind. And Roda getting the win over Heracles. Feyenoord, the big game, of course. Who are they playing this week? They're away to Heerenveen. That is interesting. Come on, Heerenveen. 3-1 to Heerenveen. Well, the sins of the PSV game could be washed away here if we beat Zvoli at home, which we really should do. Feyenoord stay third, actually. If we win this game, we're 9 clear of AZ and we are 10 clear of Feyenoord. One win, one draw and one loss against Zvoli so far in our time here. Savastano back in for Kemper, which means Farkas dropping out altogether. No, come on, Kemper back there. There we go. We're gonna bring Nunnally on for Kluivert. Kluivert's been very iffy recently. There's nobody else on the bench that we really want to bring in. So that will be Roy Grock, Van Gelderen, De Ligt, Kemper, Backboard, Savastano, Van de Beek, Eating, Nunnally, Serhuis, and Dekker. How's Kemper getting on? He's training okay. He's 19 years of age now, though. I'd like to see some more stat development on him. First touch, probably, we should be working on. It's only 10 at the moment. His passing's 13, so certainly get a good pass on him, but he needs that first touch a bit more polished if he's going to be a solid ball-playing defender going forward. Right, I expect nothing but a win today. Let's keep it simple. Let's not say anything to them from the off. Let's just let them go out there and do their work. They need to bounce back for the PSV defeat. Are they going to win this and remain 9 clear at the top? The games are running out for anybody to catch us. But statistically, we're getting hammered a wee bit here. 3 shots to none in their favour in the opening 15. Starting to wrestle control of possession a little bit now, but we're still not creating anything. Savastano nicking it, though. That's the difference he makes when he's back. Dekker, long-range drive, well wide. But it is something. Savastano with that athleticism out there on the left. He is a good athlete, right? I'm not just making things up. Yeah, I mean, it's quite good pace and agility and stuff. Certainly quicker off the mark than Boy Kemper is. Again, I think... No, he's not actually. Acceleration, pace. Kemper's pretty similar to him. Van Polen to Amrabat. Marinus, Amrabat. Into the middle, Nyland slips it to Thomas. But Bord with a great challenge. Scrambled away and it will break actually for Nunnally now. Flicking it to Serhuis for Dekker. Good ball in between the defenders. He's forced wide with no help. Holds it up. Back to Savastano. Good play. Dekker now into Van de Beek, who's hit the post. That was really good play by Dekker there, actually. Not to just hit a crappy shot from a tight angle or something. He actually held it up and did well to get it in. on Dan though, coming forward for them. Beats his man, gets into the box, squares it up. Delight gets the header away. As Marinus goes back to Van Pollen, Amrabat now on Dan, picking it up again. How long is this highlight? Amrabat now, Van Pollen. There we go, it's just going to end randomly. Van de Beek in, header away, Carl Eating holding it up, doesn't really have the pass. Go back if you need to, son. Goes all the way back to the keeper, that's fine. Rather that than lose it and let them counter. Van Gelderen finding backboard now. Down the line for Nunley. What a pass that is. Nunley gets across, cut back. Eating! What a finish! Well done, son. Well done indeed. I was taking a drink there. I couldn't express my suspense in any better way than that. Van de Beek out to backboard, drill it across, son. Stands it up, Decker's there, but it's headed away from him. Savastano now, he drills it across. Nunley goes down, pen given, and the big man Sir House is going to step up to the mark for goal number 30 something of the season. No sweat, no danger, never going to miss. Hits the post. Deary, deary me, son. Deary me. Right, I'm just going to tell him don't get complacent. Sir House looks stressed, that's why he's going to come off for Eric Koning. He's not played great today. Donny van de Beek is going to come off for Noah Lang. And we're going to continue with that. 1-0 so far is a bit precarious for me, but we should have the quality to get another. Cadel Eating, the only player other than Roy Grock who has a 7 or better. Doesn't he say a lot about how well the team's played overall today? Decker's corner now. Header away easily. Eating back to Decker, surely. Yep, acres of space. Beats a man, drills it. And a penalty's given. Koning being pulled back, apparently. Nunley steps up. We've missed one so far. Surely we can't miss two. It's Nunley. It's in. He does what Sir House was trying to do. Tucks it into the corner. Who we bring? We'll bring on De La Vega for Decker. De La Vega's not really done much for us this season. He's really a forgotten man now. Eating, drilling it low, and it's deflected in. Eric Backer, or Eric Baker. 3-0 to Ajax, and now all of a sudden we're cruising. Lang intercepting a throw-in. Koning now, Nunley. We're looking to rack up some goals now. It's a speculative effort, well wide in the end, but hey, at least we're in a good, confident position now. And that's with us missing a penalty. A good game for Carl Eating today. Nunley did well also in that right-hand side of the forward line. Everybody's actually played relatively well today. Corner in from Lang. Kemper's up, flicking it on. Nunley down in the chest. Tees up Eating, who blasts another one. Van der Hart makes a good save. Would have been even better than his first goal, that one. But it is well saved by the Zvolle goalkeeper. It's Carl Eating again to bend one from distance. Delight will turn it in, but will be offside, surely. Yeah, he is indeed. And it's probably going to tick out now for 3-0. We're way over the allotted 3 added minutes. When Pollen with the throw-in, it is over at 3-0. Comfortable in the end. Yeah, well done, lads. Good win for us. Let's not go too overboard with the praise here. We beat the bottom side there. And a comfortable home win. 21 points left to play for, and we are currently 9 points clear of our closest challengers. With 21 less to play for, about 4 more wins, and we should secure the title. So listen, it's a mixed bag today, actually. The PSV result was a reminder that we're not quite as good as we might think we are. We've got a couple of tough games coming up, actually. Obviously the Real Madrid game. Then we've got Groningen at home, which we should win. But then we're away at Vitesse and Excelsior. Excelsior, who've done pretty well this season for themselves. So there's going to be interesting games there. But next time, of course, we're focusing on Real Madrid and Groningen, who are both coming to us in Amsterdam, so we don't need to go away for a while. Hopefully we can get the win over Groningen. A win over Real Madrid would be a nice confidence boost, but I can't see us beating them 4-0 going through. So obviously come back for that one next time to see how we do against Real Madrid at least. But listen, I hope you've enjoyed this one at least. Leave a like on the video if you have done, and please subscribe to the channel, follow the lads and their progress this season, see if we can see out the title and maybe win that Dutch Cup as well. But mostly, as I always say guys, thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time for Real Madrid and Groningen.